The Polish negative pronouns, nikt and nic, part 2. Grammatical case of the Polish negative pronouns. Nikt and nic are no different from other Polish pronouns, in that they change the endings based on the grammatical function in the sentence. Both pronouns have separate forms in each cases. Nominative nikt, nic. Genitive nikogo, niczego. Dative nikomu, niczemu. Accusative nikogo, nic. Instrumental nikim, niczym. Locative nikim, niczym. If these forms remind you of something, you are probably thinking of the interrogative pronouns kto, who, and co, what. Nikt and nic are actually their negative counterparts. All the forms in the table, with the exception of the base forms nikt and nic, have been created by adding ni to the corresponding forms of kto and co. Now we are going to look at forms case by case. Nominative nikt and nic. The nominative forms nikt and nic are used to talk about the subject of the sentence. You mostly use them to say that nobody or nothing did anything. Nobody or nothing is someone or something. Dlaczego nikt nic nie robi? Why isn't anybody doing anything? Prawie nikt mu nie wierzył. Almost nobody believed him. Nic się nie stało. Nothing happened. Nic nie cieszy Stevena. Nothing makes Steven happy. Genitive nikogo, niczego. The genitive forms nikogo and niczego are used to refer to 1. The direct object in a negative sentence. 2. The direct object of verbs such as szukać, to look for, potrzebować, to need, or używać, to use. 3. Objects following the prepositions dla, for, od, from, and do, to. Nikogo tam nie ma. There is nobody there. Steven się do nikogo nie odzywa. Steven doesn't talk to anybody. Nie zauważyłam niczego podejrzanego. I didn't notice anything suspicious. Nie potrzebuję niczego. I don't need anything. Dative nikomu, niczemu. The purpose of the dative forms nikomu and niczemu is referring to. Number one, the indirect object of the sentence, someone or something to whom or for whom an action is done. Number two, the object of verbs such as dawać, to give, wierzyć, to believe, dziękować, to thank, or pomagać, to help. Nikomu nie powiedziałam. I haven't told anybody. Nikomu nie otwieraj drzwi. Don't open the door to anyone. Ona niczemu nie wierzy. She doesn't believe anything. Niczemu nie zaprzeczył. He didn't deny anything. Accusative. Nikogo, nic. The accusative forms nikogo and nic mostly appear after verbs, indicating some kind of motion or after specific combinations of verbs and prepositions such as czekać na, to wait for. Nie czekam na nikogo. I am not waiting for anybody. Dorota nie wyjdzie za mąż za nikogo innego. Dorota will not marry anybody else. Steven o nic nie prosił. Steven didn't ask for anything. Nie liczyłam na nic specjalnego. I didn't expect anything special. Instrumental, nikim, niczym. Uses of the instrumental forms nikim and niczym usually involve one of the following. Number one, the verbs być, to be, zostać, to become. Number two, certain prepositions such as z, with, przed, before, in front of, and za, behind. Number three, the means equals the instrument used to do something. Przed nikim nie uciekam. I am not running from anybody. Steven z nikim nie rozmawia. Steven doesn't talk to anybody. Twoje problemy są niczym w porównaniu z jego. Your problems are nothing compared to his. To jego ulubiony długopis. Nigdy nie pisze niczym innym. This is his favorite pen. He never right with anything else. Locative, nikim, niczym. The locative forms nikim and niczym are only used together with a certain prepositions, among others, or, about, w, in, and na, on. O nikim nie rozmawiamy. We aren't talking about anybody. Dorota nigdy się w nikim nie zakochała. Dorota never fell in love with anybody. Ona nie jest w niczym dobra. She is not good at anything. Steven jeszcze o niczym nie wie. Steven doesn't know about anything yet. To wszystko na dzisiaj. Do zobaczenia.